I'm looking across to Cradle Mountain. I think Cradle Mountain was this one, could be that one. This is actually Barn Bluff.
There. No, that's Mount Pelion.
Mount Pelion. Over to the right was...
where are you looking now?
Now
yeah,
I'm looking...
The pointy one, according to this, is Barn Bluff.
Right, yeah.
There's Mount Emmett, a little one on this side of it.
And Cradle...
And then Cradle Mountain, the biggie over there.
Yeah. Heading back to the car, and you can see the hydro roads going over to little dams. Just been driving through some beautiful green countryside in the evening. This is Mole Creek Pub, now a guest house. Now we've driven all the way along this beautiful road. This is the biggest sign for tourists I've seen. There's the King Solomon's. And then we went up to the Gullet, Devil's Gullet. One of those lovely evenings. Everybody's here in Deloraine. These are all found on the floorboards of the master bedroom. This is in the publican's house. This is the bar, in the bar room of the old pub. The family lived in the building as well. Thank you. Yep. Bottomless bottles.
Tin whistles on top.
They're building a couple of homes, old homes. Lovely lavender patch. And then across the river, across town to, looks like Westbury, one of the old homesteads.
Of the Deloraine community artwork created in soft sculpture. It is called Yarns because of the many stories told and the thousands upon thousands of meters of thread used in its construction. Yarns is the brainchild of Ned Terry, who was inspired by a theatre curtain he saw in Griffith, New South Wales.
The project began in 1991 when a municipality, working with artistic director Nisi van der Elst Brown, various ideas were combined to make nearly 300 pairs of hands. Creation of the panels began after several months developing the design, the dominant features of which are the Meander River and the Great Western Tiers.
About 25 groups and many individuals brought to the project a great range of creative talents and innovations in colour and design.
It's three-dimensional. There's the caravan park. Up there.
Can you see the tents?
This little walk bridge, we'll have to do that.
We'll do it every winter, every summer.
There's a train. A 6K drive in here along a very windy little forestry road, past some very large stumps left over from the old logging days. I really don't know how they got them out on the bullocks. They built a fireplace inside that one. Quite hard, is it? Looks like
artificial.
Looks like chocolate. Soft, but it's woody and hard. Yeah, very tough.
But it looks like an artificial one.
Just another lovely wet, damp rainforest. Coming up to 5 o'clock down to Liffey Falls. Beautiful tessellated pavement. They said they fractured 175 million years ago when Tasmania broke away from Gondwana land. And also we have some boulders dropped from the Western Tiers, from the moraines, from 12,000 year old glaciers. Drop stones from the glacier. They could have been carried from as far away as Cradle Mountain and dropped here when the glacier is melted. Birch trees are sprouting with lovely new growth on them. Foamy whirlpool there. There's one in the cave we saw yesterday, an old one that was long dead and gone, in the roof. Now we're descending above these falls, going further down. It really is very green. A different colour balance. getting a bit dangerous to get across. I'm in a cave now, it goes in behind. Quite a way in here, in the back. About 5 meters in. And then the riverbed here, we got these stones and fossils and the shells.
And I decided whatever it was, they'd measured the circumference at the base, not at the walkway. That's a stringy bark.
Oh, we had an inch and a half of rain last night. Poured. Now the sun's out. And the river's bigger than the Murrumbidgee. And the ducks had trouble getting across. Place at St Mary's at Hagley, we saw a poppy field surrounding the church there. Tasmania supplies half the world in another little church there, surrounded by opium fields, poppies. I just spent half an hour or more in this little gift shop over here looking at a fantastic array of toys and dolls and chooks and you name it. A lovely village green in the centre of Longford. You can't take a trick. Just gotta take the bag with the good, I suppose. Oh, he's okay. I don't mind them peddling in front of the photo. Somewhere in this street we had our Devonshire teas with Gwen and Francis and the kids. It's all been well preserved. Looks like they have a bit of rain through here as well. This is the first basin, that's the chairlift across to the rotunda. Wave your arms.
Did you see the one on the roof that is tail up?
Just walked along there. I'm doing a quick trip back along the zigzag scenic walk for intrepid walkers only, it says. There's the King Bridge back of Launceston.
Launceston.
It is too. Well, we're at the top of the zigzag track. We're going downhill now. Oh. And we've come all the way around this beautiful gorge. Wish we had more sunshine. There's not many people left on the track now. We're driving up Ben Lomond now. The clouds have come in. We'll have to wait too long for the sun to come out. Now Barrow in the top right, top left corner, and here's the zigzag, Jacob's Ladder it's called, constructed in 1966 up this scree slope. One of the most spectacular drives in Australia, I'd say. One of the most specky drives. Running out of video, we might have enough to get us going down. You can see out to the coast, that's Ben Nevis up there. You can see the beaches. And these are the ski fields at the village at the top of Ben Lomond. A couple of ski lifts we've got as well. Top of it is up there, Leg Tor. It looks a bit of a cloudy day at the moment. There's not very much wind, so it's not going to blow away. It's all very oldy-worldy. And from the 1950s, nothing very much has happened here for quite a few years, I think. This is on an Alden Face car villa. It used to be the way up before they had the road out of the Scout Hall. The track goes up over the top there, you can walk up an hour and a half. Now we're just driving north up the Tamar Valley. This is looking south back to Launceston. Just about 10k from Batman Bridge. Our little navigational lead light, the second one, the red one back there down the road, and here's the Lowerhead lighthouse. We'll go up to it in a minute. That's the lead light down there, nestled in amongst the large retirement village. That's one of the leading light.